Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by the confession of your name and by baptism, we may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up our hearts to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to obey your Lord. But on this day above all, to Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, give life to all things and make them holy,
and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the recording of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by his death and will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ.
May it make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may be
Saviour's command, informed by my teaching, we know to stand and say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
for us, Lord, we pray for every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, our Lord, and the Lord, now
and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with thy spirit. Speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Bring your hand and feel the place of the nails. Doubt no longer, but believe. Alleluia. The body of Christ.
Amen. Amen.